once again. The first chair we're going to launch today is Dr. S.R. Rajagopalan Chair in the Department of Chemistry. Dr. S.R. Rajagopalan is an alumnus and a distinguished scientist in electrochemistry, and he has kindly agreed to lend his name for this institute chair in chemistry department. Dr. Rajagopalan received his PhD in 1970 in the Department of Chemistry. He worked in the areas of optical properties of electrode deposited films, which ultimately culminated in his PhD. Based on his research records and publications, IIT Madras admitted him to PhD directly without an MSc degree, which is a very rare honor in those days. After completing his experimental work, he joined NAL in 1967 and continued his R&D efforts till he retired in 1991 as a scientist G. Rajagopalan worked on applied research, developing know-hows and transferring them to industries. Concept to commercialization was his passion. He and his team developed 18 know-hows and worked closely with industries to commercialize the same. His R&D activities spanning over 4 decades led to publications of 164 research papers, 76 reports, 11 patents and 18 know-hows. His research is multifaceted. It covers electrochemistry, corrosion, electrochemical instrumentation, surface modification, surface engineering and trace analysis. He was a supervisor for 9 PhD programs. He received many awards in his distinguished career. We are indeed thankful to Dr. Rajagopalan for his gesture in lending his name to his chair, and I now request Dr. Rajagopalan to come on stage to share a few words.
Good evening to all of you. Thank you, Professor Subramanian. I started my research career in the year 1953, and for 16 years I was engaged in academic research. Then for 27 years I was in the field of applied research. In a sense, my R&D career continues even today. I am interacting with a couple of industries, helping them to understand the know-why or the know-how which they are practicing. I would like to briefly share with you one of my exciting experience in doing applied research. Forgive me for stalking some shop. It was at the time when INSAT 2A was being planned. The Space Department approached us to develop a cooler for the infrared sensor. You are all very familiar with the cloud picture the INSAT sends. This is something which is shown in TV during monsoon time and is also published in newspapers. This cloud picture is taken by an infrared sensor, and it has to be kept at a temperature of less than 100 degree Kelvin for its efficient functioning. So a cooler is required. The cooler is based on the simple principle of radiative cooler using deep space as a sink. The cooler is nothing but 4 mirrors, trapezoidal in shape, forming a trapezoidal cavity, and the floor of the cavity, the sensor is mounted on the floor of the cavity. The size of the mirror is very large, is 0.6 meter by 0.3 meter, and it has to be out of aluminum because of light weight and high strength. For the efficient functioning of this cooler, the surface has to have flatness of 1 micron, and then the surface roughness should be less than 10 nanometers. Aluminum cannot be finished to that level, so you require some kind of surface modification in order to achieve that one. And ISRO told us, develop this mirror in 18 months' time. 3 months after we started, Professor Satish Dhawan, the then chairman of ISRO, called me for a meeting and told me, I know you don't have the technology. If you are confident of developing the technology, I will stop the import of this cooler. Otherwise, I will have to go ahead with importing this cooler. Driven by passion to do applied research, I replied with a jerk in my heart and trembling voice, I am confident. Subsequently, this meeting triggered hectic activity in my team, and we were trying to develop this mirror. The biggest task is to achieve the planarity of 1 micron and surface roughness less than 10 nanometers, that is 0.01 micron. So first, we put in a hard layer of nickel cobalt, and with that, we could achieve the planarity of 1 micron by polishing it. But however much we polished, we could not reduce the roughness below 100 nanometers, that is 0.1 micron. Then an in-depth study of SEM told us that the problem is with difference in the rate of polishing of the grain and the grain boundary, as a result of which the grain boundaries were forming ridges on the surface, and that contributed to the roughness. The moment we realized, the way forward was very clear to us. Put an amorphous layer which does not have a grain boundary and we will get over the problem. And we put an electroless nickel on top of that one and we polished. Lo and behold, we reached 7 nanometers of roughness. We thought we had reached the goal. We submitted a sample to ISRO. They evaluated. They said everything is fine, but there is one problem. The surface absorption is 38% and our design calls for absorption less than 25%. Then we put a top layer of aluminum on top, and that increased the roughness slightly by 1.5 nanometers, so it became 8.5 nanometers, but still it is below the 10, which is the specification limit. And the surface absorption became 15%. With that, we thought we have achieved everything, and we made the mirrors. These were used in INSAT 2A, and I don't want to take too much of your time. When INSAT was launched, of course, we had for a couple of days very anxious time. Then ISRO told us, saying, we have evaluated the cooler and the cooler is maintaining the temperature of the sensor at 96 degree Kelvin and the limit is 100. So we were very happy about it, and pictures of very fine quality were being sent by INSAT. 8 years rolled by, then INSAT 2A had completed its mission successfully. ISRO assessed the condition of the cooler, because there is a requirement that the cooler at the end of the life of the satellite should have a temperature lower than 112 degree Kelvin. And this cooler was at 160 degree Kelvin, so it functioned very well. Based on this success story, NIL has been supplying cooler to every satellite that is launched by ISRO. The cooler that is made by NIL costs 10 lakhs of rupees. The imported cooler costs 60 crores of rupees. Thus, we could contribute to self-reliance in a critical area, and that too at an economical cost. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. We are indeed honored to have your name associated with this chair. This chair, as you mentioned earlier, has been fully funded, and I'm happy to announce that this chair has been fully funded by our distinguished alumnus, Mr. D. Chandrasekhar of 1970 batch. Thank you, DC, as he is fondly called by his friends and associates. DC, apart from contributing to this chair, has also been involved in contributing to 2 more chairs, and collectively, his funds donation to IIT this year has crossed 1 crore. I think it requires a great amount of applause. Thank you so much. More important than mere contribution of funds, DC has devoted a lot of time, energy, towards building the alumni relationship, and the relationship has strengthened over a period of past decades. A great deal of credit goes to DC's involvement in making this happen. And once again, one more thank you, sir. I also invite you to come down and share a few thoughts on this occasion.
Friends, a very good evening. I'm extremely happy to be part of this alumni function this evening, where we will be enduring 6 chair professorships in various departments, distribute awards and prizes, including a few distinguished alumnus awards. The reason I am privileged to stand before you today and speak is due to my extraordinary teachers in the Ramakrishna Mission School, and later due to the excellent professors of IIT Madras who provided me value-based education. As I am turning 70, it's time for Thanksgiving. And who should I thank first, if not IIT Madras? It's because of IIT Madras that I have performed well as a first-generation entrepreneur. I'm involved in a variety of social causes that include helping children with dyslexia, restoration of heritage temples, and other social causes in health and education. Graduating with a degree in metallurgy in the year 1970, I have maintained a close association with my alma mater, and I have remained a part of the alumni movement all through. I'm proud to be the founder trustee and present secretary of the IIT Madras Alumni Charitable Trust, and a recipient of the Distinguished Alumnus Award in the year 2009. In my career as a first generation entrepreneur, IIT Madras has always remained the first place to go to whenever I had a problem. I must be thankful for the wonderful support I got from them during my early days of entrepreneurship. When we were entering the business of electrolysis nickel plating, which was quite a nascent activity at the industrial level, we did have a technical tie-up with a British company, but it did not help us as we were continuously facing unpredictable problems. At this point, Dr. S.R. Rajagopalan came into the picture. The problems vanished gradually, and we became one of the largest coaters in the country. All our customers used to request us to bring Dr. Rajagopalan and conduct workshops in ENP, since the technology had never been taught to their engineers in their colleges. He further advised us to take up gold coating backed up by electrophoretic coating, that not only on metals but also on a variety of non-metals including leaves, that has taken us to over 150 temple projects. We are proud to be advising Tirupati Devasthanam and the new temple project that's coming up near Hyderabad at Yadagiri Gutta. We owe it all to Dr. S.R. Rajagopalan, a brilliant scientist who spent most of his time working with National Aeronautical Lab, alumnus of IIT Madras, and a great human being. He has done great work in the field of surface technology and is advising large industries. Yet he gave us the precious time that turned the tide in our favor. He has already shared his experience in a Make India project. It is for this reason that I offered to create a chair in the name of Dr. S.R. Rajagopalan in the physical chemistry department, from where he got his PhD. I have also offered to provide a matching contribution to create a chair professorship in the name of Professor M.A. Parameswaran in the Department of Mechanical Engineering. Professor Parameswaran is an engineer par excellence, and I had the opportunity to see his passion and dedication for his work firsthand. I am a qualified metallurgy graduate, and early in my career, I took up chemical plant equipment building that needed a lot of mechanical engineering designs. We needed to design and manufacture salt ionization plants in the late 80s and early 90s against international competition. We sought the help of Professor Parameswaran, who was then the head of the mechanical engineering and mechanical handling and machine elements lab at IIT. He used to visit us at Ambattur and provide us the needed advice. In those days, IIT was very non-commercial in their approach to consultancy. We used to get bills of 2,000 to 3,000 rupees per month. And I do not know what portion went to Professor Parameswaran. But he helped us due to his love for his work. I remember the only thing that I could give him, which he enjoyed, was the masala dosa at the end of every visit. This What we got in return was an excellently designed equipment, and we remained a single source for this equipment with UNICEF for over 15 years, and also earned the top exporter award from the Engineering Export Council, Promotion Council in 91-92 and 94-95. We owe it all to Professor Parameshwar. There is yet another angle to our relationship. Professor Parameshwaran, as the president of the IIT Madras Alumni Association, was instrumental for the formation of the IIT Madras Alumni Charitable Trust. That, in turn, has set up the development office about which Subbu has been talking. I understand Professor Shankar Narayanan and Professor A. Ramesh will be occupying the physical chemistry and mechanical engineering chairs respectively. I congratulate both of them and wish them all success in their endeavors. I have also offered to make a token contribution to the chair in the chemical engineering department to be occupied by Professor R. Nagaraj. I do hope IITM creates a chair in the name of Professor Nagarajan in the future, when I can have the privilege of making a greater contribution. We have worked together in the last 10 years, and due to his persistent and perseverant approach to alumni relations and fundraising, IIT Madras has surpassed all other IITs in these areas. One of the recent projects that was completed through the initiative of OAA and Development Office is the 2 megawatt solar facility that could save IIT Madras over 1 crore a year. This is a CSR initiative of Rural Electricity Corporation. My experience in working with such individuals with high integrity and dedication to their work has spurred me to give back to society. These individuals point us to the road that seems to be less taken nowadays. For we seem to be forgetting that in selfless giving, we receive more than we give. It's for this reason that I have chosen to contribute to the chair professorships and various other causes like dyslexia. I am indeed indebted to my wife and children, who have been very understanding and supportive of my initiatives. A quick word on dyslexia, which is my passion subject. At Madras Dyslexia Association, we are trying to empower primary school children to remediate dyslexic children in their schools. These children have average to above average intelligence, and they form 15% of the school-going children. Without remediation, they drop out and cause social problems. Even in this effort, IIT has promptly come to our support by agreeing to help us with the digitization of the training. I offer my sincere thanks to Professor Andrews, Bharati, Kannan, and Sri Balaji, and others in the NPTEL team who have been very supportive. In summary, it has been an honor and privilege to be an IITM alumnus and in my own way serve the institution and our society. Thank you.
Thank you very much, TC. Your contribution has been to 3 chairs today. That's about 50% of chairs to be launched today. Thanks once again. It brings 2 good people to create a wonderful chair here. The third person who is going to occupy is equally interesting personality. That is Professor M.V. Sankaranarayanan of Chemistry Department. He obtained his PhD from Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. He joined IIT Madras as assistant professor in 1993. He has made outstanding research contributions in theoretical as well as experimental electrochemistry. The only person from IIT Madras chosen for Professor C.N.R. Rao National Prize for Research in Chemical Sciences, and as a president of the Society of Advancement in Electrochemical Science and Technology in India. He has given research guidance to over 14 PhD students and has about 120 journal papers. I would like to invite Professor Shankar Narayan to share a few thoughts on this occasion.
Dear Professor Bhaskar Ramamurthy, Professor Nagarajan, Dr. S. Rajagopalan, I am very happy to be involved in this very happy function. I know Dr. SRR when I was in JRF at the IASC Bangalore. He was a very close friend of my own PhD guide, S.K. Rangarajan. They used to tell that there is a triumvirate in Bangalore, Professor S.K. Rangarajan, S. Satyanarayana, and Dr. S.R. Rajagopalan. I also remember those days Bangalore was the very happening place in electrochemistry. We had Professor A.K.N. Reddy, whose book in electrochemistry is even today very classic. A almost all universities are following the book by A.K. Reddy. We had Professor K. Vasu, who became director of CECRI Karaikudi. These three, S.K. Rangarajan, Satyanarayanan, S.R. Rajagopalan, A.K. Reddy, K. Vasu, T.L. Ramachar, and many others. One very unique thing I would like to emphasize about S.R. Rajagopalan, which he didn't mention, most of the solutions that he gave for industrial problems were down to earth. It is very, very simple and unique, clever method of solving any issue. I think a few, 1 or 2 years back, he came to me with a particular issue, and he came to me, this can be solved easily by multivariate statistical methods, and he took one book also from me. Very voluminous data, he can analyze extremely well. He has a very clever method of looking at an issue and giving a very simple solution which almost every other person misses. Another contribution that I would like to emphasize here is the electrochemical machining. In fact, his name is synonymous with electrochemical machining. I also understand that many of the aircraft designs, he has actually made very intricate designs. And also some of the nuclear reactors that he also mentioned. Also many contributions he made in the Indian Railway, thereby saving enormous foreign exchange. His name is extremely valuable. His contribution is very, very important in terms of import substitution. So I am very happy to be associated with his name in this launching officer also. And I also thank the Professor Nagarajan and all the others associated with this. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. We would like to formally launch this chair by director receiving a check from the donor, Mr. DC. Can I request Mr. DC and director to come on stage? I also request Shankar Narayan and Dr. Rajagopalan to join